Well, this temporary arrangement turned out to be permanent. And so starting in 1962, I had two research groups, two research laboratories. One, my old laboratory in Louvain, and the other one, the new lab, that turned out to be, ended up being quite large, a whole floor in a new building there in New York. And how it worked out, well, you better ask my wife and my children. They certainly paid a price for this dual life of mine, because at the age of my children, it was not possible for the whole family to accompany me. It would be, have been too expensive anyway. My wife did come with me from time to time, but always for very relatively short stays, so that we could leave the children with friends or leave them in the house with a person to take care of them. And so I was absent from home quite a lot, and I'm sure the family paid a price for that. But they're not too unhappy today, so I'm trying to not feel too guilty about it. Scientifically, I can only say it was a tremendous success, because the lab in New York turned out to be extremely productive. I was able to recruit another group of people, graduate students, postdocs, and we managed to keep the two labs, working and successfully working, thanks to the fact that I had such wonderful co-workers in Belgium. And I haven't said enough about them. I've mentioned Géry Hers largely, but Géry Hers, he never came to New York. He was doing his own thing, and he was being extremely successful in his work on carbohydrate metabolism, making important discoveries even after he discovered the lysosomal diseases. And so he had his own group, a big group. And but besides Hers, I had Jacques Berthet, whom I mentioned in the beginning, Robert Wattiaux, Henri Beaufay, Pierre Baudhuin, Pierre Jacques, André Trouet, Gilbert Vaes, all the Belgians. And most of them spent at least a year with me in New York. So every year I had one of my Belgian seniors to come over in New York and to take care of the New York lab while I was coming back to Belgium to do my teaching, and because I still did a small amount of teaching, and to take care of the Belgian lab. And so together with these people, I was able to run those two labs quite successfully. In fact, the two labs, let us say, they collaborated very much on techniques, but didn't compete on subjects. They worked on parallel subjects, mostly using the same techniques, the same approaches. And I think one very important achievement of those days was the development of new and better techniques and instruments for the fractionation of cells and tissues. And in this, I was very much helped by Berthet, Jacques Berthet, and especially Henri Beaufay,